Chris Olak and Tony Grossi for the Daily Grossi today. And Tone, we have a game to react to, the Hall of Fame game, Browns getting the win over the Jets. But before we do that, on Friday, we did hear from head coach Kevin Stefanski with some news, some injury news. What can you tell us? What is the latest here?
Yeah, you know, it didn't look like the Browns suffered a major injury in the game, but it turned out they did, actually two. The coach said that wide receiver Daylon Baldwin, who was announced as leaving with a hamstring injury, he termed that a significant injury, did not put a timetable on how long he'll be out. But when he uses a word like significant,
right,
he doesn't overhype it. Also, cornerback Thomas Graham suffered another significant injury to his ankle. Both of these players were right on the periphery, on the bubble. The time loss for them will be extremely costly.
Anything else from Stefanski today of note?
Well, I know we'll get into Cade York.
Yes, we will.
Tried not to express any concern about missing the field goal. And I guess the first PAT was just leaked, tucked inside the right upright. I couldn't tell where I was sitting in the press box, but that's what people tell me. So they're still not expressing concern, but I guarantee you if he doesn't make them in the Washington game, there's going to be some concern. But
yeah, let's stick there, Tone, just real quick, since we're on the topic of Cade York. At what point, I guess, how long is the leash? How, if he misses another kick this upcoming week against Washington, could we expect some competition brought in?
It's going to be interesting to see how they react, Chris. You don't want to add pressure to him. We all see him. He's automatic at practice. Just automatic. He looks like Greg Zuerlein did in the game other day. So it's obviously above his shoulders. And if you're the coach, you have to wonder, now, if I bring someone in, is that going to help or hurt the situation?
Right.
So I just think at this point, Cade York needs to go into the Cincinnati game, the regular season opener, in a good frame of mind. And for that to happen, he's got to make, you know, all the makeable kicks.
Right.
So I'm sure this is going to be a pressure situation against Washington for him. No matter if it's a PAT or a short field goal, he's got to start making them.
Yeah, fair enough. I totally agree. All right, there was some good play on the field last night, Tone. From the quarterback position, Dorian Thompson-Robinson, DTR, played a really solid second half. Kellen Mond in the first half, it felt a little flat. Your feel on these two quarterbacks after the first game?
It struck me the first half reminded me of Jacoby Brissett. The second half reminded me of what we think Deshaun Watson's going to be. And that's the way that Dorian Thompson-Robinson played. He was electric. He provided the juice to get the team to overcome their first half mistakes. He gave the fans something to cheer about. He gave us all something to talk about. I'm not sure that that's a position battle anymore at this point. I mean, I felt going in, Chris, that DTR, it was his job to lose because he was the drafted, the anointed draftee. And Kellen Mond had to be like a heavyweight contender. He had to knock him out over the course of this training camp or preseason to win the QB3 job.
Right.
So he didn't, he certainly didn't. He hit the canvas himself rather than the other way around. So I think DTR showed that this game's not too big for him at this stage.
Yeah. Now this is me at least. You have to take it with a grain of salt because of who he was playing against. But in terms of playing time the rest of the preseason, I have to imagine, Tony, that is directly related to how much time Kevin Stefanski wants to give Deshaun Watson, right?
Right. And Dobbs for that matter.
And Dobbs, yes.
So game three against Philadelphia, we know pretty much that the starters won't play in that game because they're going to be practicing hard for 2 days in controlled scrimmages. So I'm thinking that'll be the next opportunity for DTR and probably Mon. Maybe they'll reverse it. Maybe they'll let DTR start that game and Mon come in the second half. But that's the way I think we're going to see. I'm more interested how much play time he gives Watson and Dobbs in game two against Washington Friday night.
Right.
I asked them that. he wouldn't show his hand. But we know both of those quarterbacks will play Friday.
Well, before we get to some of the other rookies around that the Browns have, quick reminder from our good friends over at BetMGM.
Yeah, attention, BetMGM customers. You have a friend who loves sports as much as you do, but here's a chance for both of you to earn a $100 bonus when they sign up through BetMGM's Refer a Friend program. Just sign into your BetMGM account, click on the Refer a Friend program to send your friend a message inviting them to register a new account in the same state that you use BetMGM. Once your friend signs up and makes the deposit, they'll receive a $100 bonus. And once your friend places a bet with their bonus and the wager is settled, you'll receive a $100 bonus as well. There's simply no better time than now to find out why BetMGM is the king of sportsbooks. So spread the word, get your friends in on the action, enjoy your bonus with BetMGM today. Must be 21 and up, present in Ohio. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER. In partnership with MGM Northfield Park.
So, Tone, on the offensive side of the ball, you had DeJuan Jones, the right tackle, played every snap on offense, looked like he held his own, had a couple of holding penalties. Cedric Tillman from the wide receiver position. Those are a couple of guys that, to me at least, showed, hey, they can belong in the NFL.
Yes. I'm sorry, I was distracted. Watkins and Tillman, did you say?
I said DeJuan Jones and Tillman. Oh, okay. I did not mention perfect, Watkins. Perfect. No.
We'll take care of him. Yeah. Hey, DeJuan Jones played every snap. That was a surprise to get through that, number one. He did great to get through it. He played pretty well. Two holding calls. You know, one was negated, but basically two holding calls. Yeah. Every offensive snap. I think he scored a lot of points with the coaches on Thursday night for doing that. Cedric Tillman just continues to look like a pretty polished receiver for a third-round rookie. He helped his chances of not only, you know, in that receiver mix. Top four right now, Marquise Goodwin out.
Yeah. You mentioned Watkins as well. I think he helped his stock, Anthony Schwartz hurting his stock. Yeah. I think ultimately for him, Tony, writing on the wall, right? Just a matter of time for Schwartz.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, he's got to be flawless with every opportunity. And he fumbled after, carrying the ball for an 8-yard gain on a jet sweep. So, it doesn't look good for him, but I'm sure they'll give him more opportunities.
We talked about the QB position where we kind of have a feel for that number three right now. Was there any other position battle down the depth chart that you got a little more clarity on following the game last night?
I thought it was interesting that Jordan Elliott was the only projected starter to play in the game, defensive tackle. He's been lining up with the number one defensive line. After the game, the coach said he just needs reps to get ready for September 10th. So that was it. That caught my interest. And, you know, a lot of those young linebackers way at the end of the depth chart had pretty good second halves. They showed up on film. I don't know if they have enough time to climb into the mix or not, but the coaches were pleased about that.
Number three running back, Demetric Felton, John Kelly. I thought both played well yesterday.
They did. And Felton really showed that he looks more like a natural running back than a natural receiver. This was his most extended opportunity running with the ball. And he's in that mix, you know, after Chubb and Jerome Ford, all those guys who played are vying for that running back three position. And even the rookie Hassan Hall, I thought had a good fourth quarter after dropping that opening kickoff. He did pretty well. So I think all those guys are in the mix. That's, you know, there's four or five guys there. That's why they haven't brought in a veteran running back, and they still might not.
So, Tony, Browns were off today. No practice today on Friday. They're back at it Saturday. Can we now expect things to start ramping up as we're getting ready now for the second full week of the preseason?
Sure. I mean, this second game, we'll see starters play. And then I think the whole next 2 weeks is geared toward peaking in the two practices against the Eagles, and then it'll start coming back down. So that will be the peak of training camp preseason. But this game Friday will be important. We'll see for the first time some of these new players that are going to be very integral players.
A couple other quick things before we get out of here today. The celebration of life for Jim Brown. I know you were there. What did you make of that 90-minute program that they put together?
It was really well done. It was fascinating. It was powerful. I learned things about Jim Brown that I never knew. It was just extremely moving to be there in that theater. Yeah. You know, with all the other Hall of Famers, there are at least 24 Hall of Famers that I could identify. They were just spellbound by some of the stuff they heard. I thought it was excellent production, and well worth viewing if you haven't seen it on video.
Yeah. We'll recap all of the Hall of Fame weekend next week when we do it, when we do our Daily Grossi starting up again on Monday. But just last thing here, Tone, going into Saturday, Joe Thomas is going to speak. What do you just expect that day to be like tomorrow in Canton?
Well, he's the ninth and last inductee to speak, and it's all we really care about. From what I gathered from interviews Joe has mentioned, he's going to pay a lot of tribute to the Cleveland fans, and that will be well received at the stadium. And it's his moment. The presentation speech is pre-recorded. It's a video of his wife and kids, and I'm sure that'll bring a tear to his eye too, just seeing them present him. I don't know if he's seen the final product of the video production
If I heard, I think I heard one of the interviews saying he hasn't seen it because he wants to see it live as it's happening.
Good for him. Yeah. And then there's that dramatic moment where they unveil his bust. Now, I know he's seen the bust already, but everyone else gets a chance to see it. So it's the absolute pinnacle day of his athletic life, that induction.
Yeah. All right, Tone, really good stuff. We had a lot to react to.
Yeah.
We're going to have a full weekend of stuff to react to next week. We'll catch up on Monday.
All right, Chris. Very good.